advertise for the world. And remember that we have problems. We pray for the living of Father Abay, Father Sabin. We pray for the eternal rest of Mother Abisina.
For the healing of Anna, Dorothy, Eric Graves, and John Spiders.
So pray for those who ask us to pray for various injunctions, people who are in hospitals, people who are in studies and difficulties in life. We pray also to celebrate the different events, birthdays, anniversaries, and the lives. We pray that the Lord can bless them and be with you.
We also pray for our order, for the general, for the prior general council, as well as for our province, most especially, and the prior provincial and council, for the Lord to continue to guide us and to help us in the challenges of the days. We also pray for our co-workers and for the today, brothers, we celebrate the memorial of Saint Augustine, who was born at Tagaste in Africa in 354. He was unsettled and restlessly searched for the truth until he was converted to the faith at Milan and baptized by others. Returning to his homeland, he embraced an ascetic life and subsequently was elected bishop of Hippo. For 34 years, he guided his flock, instructing it with sermons and many writings. He fought bravely against the errors of his time and explained the faith carefully and cogently through his writings. He died in 430. We begin our celebration. In the name of the Father, Son of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And be with yours. Amen.
Together with the Universal Church, let us pray the Psalms. O Lord,
in your light we see light itself.
Sin speaks to the sinner in the depths of his heart, there is no fear of God before his eyes.
He so flatters himself in his mind that he knows not his guilt. In his mouth are mischief and deceit, all wisdom is gone.
He plots the defeat of goodness as he lies on his bed. He has set his foot on evil ways, he clings to what is evil.
Your love, Lord, reaches to heaven, your truth to the skies. Your justice is like God's mountain, your judgments like the deep.
To both man and beast you give protection. O Lord, how precious is your love. My God, the sons of men, find refuge in the shelter of your wings.
They feast on the riches of your house. They drink from the stream of your delight. In you is the source of life, and in your light we see light.
Keep on loving those who know you, doing justice for upright hearts. Let the foot of the proud not crush me, nor the hand of the wicked cast me out.
See how the evildoers fall, come down, they shall never arise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
O Lord, in your light we see light itself.
O God, you are great and glorious.
We marvel at your power.
Strike up the mouth, the instruments, a song to my God with timbrels. Chant to the Lord with cymbals, sing to him a new song. exalted and praised his name.
And in your name I will sing to my God. O Lord, great are you and glorious, wonderful in power and unsurpassable.
Let every creature serve you, for you spoke and they were made. You sent forth your spirit and they were created. No one can resist your word.
The mountains to their bases and the seas are shaken. The rocks like wax melt before your glance. But to those who fear you, you are very merciful.
Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
O God,
you are great and glorious. You marvel at your power. Exalt in God's presence with hymns of praise. All peoples clap your hands. Cry to God with shouts of joy. For the Lord the Most High you must fear, great King over all the earth.
He subdues peoples under us and nations under our feet. Our inheritance, our glory is from him, given to Jacob out of love.
God goes up with shouts of joy. The Lord goes up with trumpet blasts. Sing praise for God, sing praise. Sing praise to our King, sing praise.
God is King of all the earth. Sing praise with all your skill. God is King over the nations. God reigns on his holy throne.
The princes of the peoples are assembled with the people of Abraham's God. The rulers of the earth belong to God who reigns over all.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Exalt in God's presence with hymns of praise. Let us pray. Renew in your church, we pray, O Lord, the spirit with which you endowed your bishop, St. Augustine, that filled with the same spirit, we may thirst for you, the sole fount of true wisdom, and seek you, the author of heavenly love, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We instruct you, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to shun any brother who walks in a disorderly way, and not according to the tradition they received from us. For you know how one must imitate us, for we did not act in a disorderly way among you, nor did we eat food received free from anyone. On the contrary, in toil and drudgery, night and day we worked, so as not to burden any of you. Not that we do not have the right, rather, we wanted to present ourselves as a model for you, so that you might imitate us. In fact, when we were with you, we instructed you that if anyone was unwilling to work, neither should that one eat. May the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times, and in every way, the Lord be with all of you. This greeting is in my own hand. Paul's. This is the sign in every letter. This is how I write. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are you who fear the Lord, who walk in his ways, for you shall give the fruit of your handiwork Blessed shall you be in favor.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Behold, thus is the man blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus, woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You are like whitewashed tombs, which appear beautiful on the outside, but inside are full of dead men's bones and every kind of filth. Even so, on the outside you appear righteous, but inside you are filled with hypocrisy and evil-doing. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You build the tombs of the prophets and adorn the memorials of the righteous. And you say, if you had lived in the days of our ancestors, we would not have joined them in shedding the prophets' blood. Thus you bear witness against yourselves that you are the children of those who murdered the prophets. Now fill up what your ancestors measured out. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, today we remember Saint Augustine, Bishop and Doctor of the Church. As they say, Saint Augustine has influenced the Church so much that most of our understanding of our faith may just have roots in the writings of St. Augustine. From his writings, we could also hear his disappointment towards himself, his self-loathing for his past mistakes because of his inability to recognize God's love for him. And instead, he allowed himself to be lost in his wanderings. His loathing for sin, in a way, is St. Augustine overwhelmed by grace and forgiveness, the renewed Augustine undressed of pretensions and hypocrisy. But that is what we are sometimes, when we tend to presume and assume a role befitting of what others think of us. And so, as religious, we try to project a sense of holiness and wisdom that people expect us to possess. But in reality, we have issues that we still are unable to face and deal with. As in our gospel reading, in order to hide the dirty laundry, we cover it with clean clothes. In order to hide the stench of death in our souls, we project a sense of holiness that would merit the admiration of men. But is that who we are? St. Paul reminded the faithful in Thessalonica in his second letter, for them not to walk in a disorderly way by doing what they want or what they think is right. Rather, they should imitate the example of the elders in the faith, Paul and his companions, in that they were not a burden to those who welcomed them. Rather, they earned their keep. This reminder of Paul is also in our rule, reminding us to be truly sincere in our serving others, in living Christ and God's love for us, as Christ lived in his self-giving sacrifice. And in our psalm, we are reminded that to walk in his way is to fear him, to love him, and to point that what we desire, to the point that what we desire is to satisfy him. Today's gospel reading presents the seventh and eighth time that Jesus called the Pharisees and the Jewish leaders as hypocrites. Their lack or even absence of love for God has emboldened them to act contrary to what they are teaching. They had a sense of entitlement, that for them the burden is for the people to bear and not for them. Hypocrisy, because they did not love God enough. Saint Augustine was restless because he felt that in his youth he did not love God enough. And with his conversion, he now dedicates his life to become worthy of the love that he received from God. Let us pray that as Saint Augustine invites us to experience God's transforming love for us, we too would be inspired in doing what God truly asked of us, that we may genuinely live out our faith. But should we see others, remember charity, be charitable with them, and allow God to do His miracle, trusting in His great love for all of mankind. Amen. Page 1397. Christ is the good shepherd who laid down his life for his sheep. Let us praise and thank him as we pray.
Nourish your people, Lord.
Christ, you decided to show your merciful love for your holy shepherds.
Let your mercy always reach us through them.
Through your request, you continue to perform the ministry of shepherd of souls.
Direct us always through our leaders,
through your holy ones, the leaders of your people, to serve as physician of our bodies and spirits.
Continue to fulfill your ministry of life and holiness in us.
You talk, you walk through the prudence and love of your saints.
Grant us continual growth in holiness under the direction of our pastors.
All this we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread we offer. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine we offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual food.
Blessed be God forever.
Let us pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Celebrating the memorial of our salvation, we humbly beseech your mercy, O Lord, that this sacrament of your loving kindness may be for us the sign of unity and the bond of charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled. The great example lends us courage. Their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we do give you thanks. As in exaltation, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Ernesto, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Queen and Beauty of Carmel, with Saint Joseph, her husband, with the Blessed Apostle, Saint Titus Bransma, Saint Teresa of Avila, Saint Augustine, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, our Lord Jesus Christ, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Body and blood of Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Capital of Sekalaya, page 1210. You inspire us, O Lord,
to delight in praising you, because you made us for yourself. Our hearts are restless until they rest in you.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel.
He has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David, through his holy prophets he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us. He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
You inspire us, O Lord,
to delight in praising you, because you made us for yourself. Our hearts are restless until they rest on you.
Let us pray. May partaking of Christ's table sanctify us, we pray, O Lord, that being made members of his body, we may become what we have received. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass has been offered. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Los Carmeli,
with his glory, Jehovah, Splendor Celi, Virgo Puerpera, Singularis, Mater Mitis, Sed Virinestia, Carmelitis, Estos.